Hey everyone, it's Casimus Lego, and today I'm going to be showing you 9 brand new custom Lego minifigures from Star Wars Episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back. And after all this time, I'm so excited to be doing this showcase. I have been working on these figures on and off since March, and due to several delays that were unfortunately out of my control, I'm finally bringing you them now. Seriously, as of writing this video, I just finished Boba Fett maybe 20 minutes ago. Just for context, I wanted to finish these minifigures to commemorate the release of LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga, which was months ago. It's crazy. But finally, they're all done, and in this video is Luke Skywalker in his Bespin fatigues, Princess Leia Organa, Han Solo, Lando Calrissian, Jedi Master Yoda, the aforementioned Boba Fett from the original trilogy, Lobot, Admiral Piet, and an upgraded Darth Vader, who I wasn't intending to remake going into this project, but after seeing Hayden Christensen don the Vader mask once again, I was inspired enough to return to the original figure and make him even better than he was before. I have wanted to make these figures since 2020, and they were originally supposed to be done last year, but as I've explained in the past, I decided to remake my New Hope figures instead since they were all extremely outdated. That ended up making me push back the Empire figures, but to compensate, Return of the Jedi figures will be coming out soon before the end of this year, rounding off the original Star Wars trilogy, allowing me to begin work on the prequels next year, which, yes, we'll begin with the large-scale Phantom Menace figure line from me. But in the meantime, I've had such a great time working on these figures. I love The Empire Strikes Back as much as the original Star Wars, and I've never had the chance to make minifigures of these characters in their classic roles from the film. This has been such a privilege, and I couldn't be more excited to start this showcase. So, without any further ado, let's get started. We're going to be starting off with Luke Skywalker in his Bespin fatigues. I am in love with this costume, and a lot of that comes from Retro Blasting, one of my favorite YouTube channels. They talk a lot about vintage Star Wars toys, and one of their most famous loves is essentially Bespin Luke, and I've kind of been attached. I really like this, the outfit. I really love the military connotations. I really love the general design and all of its elements, so getting, you know, being able to make it in Lego on my own was amazing. It was really, you know, a great opportunity to be able to do this, and I've been actually working on it since maybe April of 2021. It was a long time ago that I painted the torso for the first time, and then I didn't touch it for a single year because I didn't get to finish the rest of the Empire figures, so this has been quite frankly a year in the making, but I'm really happy with it. There is a lot of three-dimensional elements on this minifigure, including the lightsaber, which is actually the Legomatic 9 and Nate minifig's lightsaber hilt, the Skywalker family hilt, the Anakin lightsaber, whatever you want to call it, it's here. I've finally been able to use it, like I mentioned a while ago, so really, really exciting. This is such a beautiful mold, and I'm really, really happy with it. I did my own painted details to it, of course. I'll give a better look at it, as I always do, but it just turned out to be a really great piece. I specifically love the igniter switch that's down there. That's made out of a piece of electrical tape that's painted, and the grips are also really nice. Standard lightsaber blade, very simple minifigure there, but minifigure accessory, I should say. But yeah, the rest of the minifigure also is really, really cool. I love all of the three-dimensional elements that go all around the figure, including all the pockets. There's pockets down here on the legs too, and around the boots there's a bit of outlining that goes around there, and then the pockets up here, those are sculpted. They were originally a 3D element, and then I decided they were too bulky, so I sculpted them instead. He's got rings around each arm. These are also just electrical tape rings. Nothing really crazy. My favorite part though are definitely the pockets up here. Those look so great. The different layers and depth that I managed to capture with the minifigure looks really sweet. Also the belts down here, those pouches, very similar to how I made a New Hope Luke, but they also came out really nice, painted in a dark umber with a very minimal detail. It's not necessary. And then this is a metal can, obviously. And then there's painting that goes down to that resembles the rest of the holster. As I move the minifigure, of course, there's a three-dimensional holster that also came out really nice. And then to the back, there is some more additional detailing with the different belts. Those are also three-dimensional pieces that came out really, really sweet. And then the hairpiece is, of course, the 2011 Mark Hamill Luke Skywalker hairpiece, whatever you want to call it. And then the head is actually really nice. There's a huge hair. I decided to use this updated Luke Skywalker head that LEGO printed maybe a few years ago. It's the Empire Strikes Back specific head, and it of course comes with the alternate expression, and it wouldn't be a Empire Strikes Back figure without the alternate arm. So removing this and replacing it with the accessory arm here, there we go. It's such a cool piece. It looks so good, and it's essentially the exact same way that this is painted, but it has its own separate details. It's got the rings around the hands where the hand was actually cut off, but it still has the pockets. It still has all the other additional details that the other arm is, you know, it has, so that's really nice. It just, you know, bunched with the alternate head here, it came out so great. Really happy with this. I think the only accessory that I would love to have with it is maybe the blaster that he uses throughout the Cloud City segments of the film, but that was something that I didn't really have time for, and I just wanted to get this figure out kind of as quickly as I can. But another detail that I feel like is kind of overlooked that I would love to point out is the waist piece down here. Some of that detailing, that's the lightsaber hook and some other accessories pieces down there on the waist piece. They're so tiny, but they came out so great. I wish that I could hang a lightsaber from it, but that's obviously not something that's possible, but it still came out really great regardless. I think I'm gonna go ahead and replace the head back to how it was, because it's you know, really nice. I didn't do much to the head also. I very briefly repainted the eyebrows and painted the hair in a, you know, my own dark tan color, but it came out really great, so I'm gonna go ahead and replace the arm back, even though you can see the terrible base color that I used, but that's kind of irrelevant. But that's it for Luke Skywalker in the Bespin outfit, the Episode 5 version of the character. Really, really happy with this one. Next up is Leia Organa in the Hoth outfit, another very iconic version of the character, and one of my biggest inspirations for minifigures, Star Wars figures especially, are the original Kenner action figures. I really love the simplicity of those original figures, and it's kind of an element of my minifigures that I try to capture, and I think that this one kind of works. It reminds me a lot of a simpler Hasbro slash Kenner type of figure especially, and I'm really, really pleased with it. It's very simplistic, but also has you know, has its own drawbacks, that being the sculpting for one. The pads over here are a little bit thick in my opinion, but they still came out really great. The blaster is also a really nice inclusion. That's from Eclipse Graphics. It's the DH-17 mold, and Lando also has one, so you know, it's a pretty standard piece from them, and it looks really nice, so I'm really happy to be able to use these pieces. All I did was paint it silver, so there's not a lot of detail there, but the control panel on the left arm over here is also really nice. It's got a few different details that I think turned out really great, and then the control panel on the jacket itself, and the jacket also is made out of electrical tape. It's not a fabric piece, because I realized that as much as I love using fabric, I should probably try using other materials for different types of clothing, and so this is more like a puffy leather kind of jacket, so I thought that it was more appropriate to use electrical tape, and I sculpted the ring around the back, which goes to the back whatnot, and there's even a bit of, you know, the painting details on here to kind of make it look like it's more puffy, but yeah, turning to the back reveals a lot of the stitch pattern. This was really, really tricky. It wasn't a lot of fun to do, but at the time I managed to get it done. When I moved to the side, you can see I did not continue the pattern. That's something that I did not want to really interact with, so I left that as is. The boots are also painted. Originally, these gray lines were actually three-dimensional, but I didn't like the way they came out. It looks a lot like the Fennec Shand minifigure that I made, but I didn't like the way that they were poking out, so I redid them and then covered them in sealant to protect the paint, and it honestly looks really great. It's a very simplistic design, but I think it perfectly captured those hot snow boots. Really, really happy with those. The torso is also really nice. I'll get into kind of a secondary figure that you can make with this, which is also really cool, but the head is also a fully painted head, much like how I did Leia last year. It's based off the Firestar Toys print, the custom print. Looks a lot like the late Carrie Fisher, and I wanted to carry that over onto my own figure, so I painted a very similar looking design, and I would have loved to just carry over the A New Hope head, but obviously I had to paint the neck there for the turtleneck, so I had to make my own head, and so I'll be doing another one for Leia when I eventually do Return of the Jedi, so yeah, this, I guess I'm gonna have to get used to this, but the hair is the standard Leia Hoth hair, and it came out really great, really standard, simple brown color. Yeah, it came out really great. Overall, a really nice minifigure. I'd love to show you this kind of a special part of the minifigure. I can totally remove this jacket just like so. It's kind of a stuck, and actually you can see a little bit of behind the scenes of how this is made. This is apparently a note card. So I was in university and just used one of my notes to make this jacket, so haha. This alternate figure kind of represents the second half of Empire Strikes Back during the escape from Bespin, so it's a kind of a two-in-one figure, really. It's very simplistic, but it works very well, actually, in her favor, so I'm gonna go ahead and put this back on. It's very simple. I'm just gonna go ahead and attach it if I can. It's gonna be a little bit tricky. Okay, we're good. There we go. Slides on just like that, and then I need to attach these arms to keep it steady. So that's about it for Leia Organa. Actually, one of my favorite figures in this entire line, just like I knew that she would, and I'm really pleased with it. Han Solo is next, and once again, another iconic outfit. We're 3 for 3 here, and it's the blue outfit from Empire Strikes Back, and this is my favorite look for Han Solo as well. As much as I love the classic scoundrel look in A New Hope, the dark brown pants and the blue jacket just looks really, really otherworldly. It's so, so good. And the minifigure captures that design almost perfectly. I have a few gripes with it, and it's mainly within the belt. I wish I could have done the belt a little bit differently, but even then, it's basically identical to the way I did the belt from A New Hope, with, you know, painted details, including the canister here, which adds a lot more detail than it did in A New Hope. So this is a completely new minifigure for the, you know, just for the records. And then the holster, I don't know, something about this holster, I love it. Its simplistic design, the fact that it comes over it, it looks so, so good. I'm really happy with that. And of course, you can kind of see that the Star Wars stripes that run down the pants, those are there as well, painted in yellow, a golden sunset color. Really, really nice. The fabric jacket, of course, is also really good, and I did have to paint some of the bits on the inside just to kind of hide some of the areas. It's something that I do with jackets every now and then, and speaking of jackets, there are three-dimensional pockets made out of fabric on each jacket. Here there's the four pockets, and on the back there's the pocket on the very, very back that goes all the way across the back of the torso, and there's also a sculpted piece up here that's a pocket. Not one on the other arm, though. There wasn't one on references, so I just left it over as one. He's got a basic pair of black boots. He's got black boots, essentially. The belt is also really nice. It's made out of fabric with a Pepsi can, soda can pop. I call it Pepsi cans. You can call it whatever you like. It doesn't matter. But, and then this is a three-dimensional pocket. It's, as I said, it's basically the exact same way that I did the A New Hope belt. And then that includes even the outlining that is to this, the side piece down here. So that's also something that I carried over from A New Hope. And then on the back, there's another pocket here with some different details. I actually ended up redoing the belt at one point. It was a lighter brown color, and I decided that just wasn't going to work for me. So I decided to make it a completely different color. And I am a lot more fond of the darker brown variant versus the yellow, the brighter variant. And speaking of which, this is a three-dimensional piece down here of electrical tape that runs to the leg, and I'm basically trying to find more things. There's cracks on the feet. Unfortunately, that can happen with minifigures. The DL-44, I realize I haven't said anything. This is also from Eclipse Graphics, and all I did was paint the tip of it silver, just like I did A New Hope Han, so there's nothing special there. This is basically just a new Han Solo, you know, made the exact same way, but from The Empire Strikes Back, and of course that, you know, includes the head, which is exactly the same. It's the Harrison Ford print that Lego is so famous for, and we move it around, and it's got the alternate expression, so perfect likeness. Didn't have to do anything, didn't even paint the eyebrows, left it completely as is, because it's 100%. Here is Chewbacca, and we'll get through this very quickly, because this is not a new minifigure. I wanted to try something new with it, but I couldn't really get it to work. I really wanted to do the C-3PO backpack, something like that, put him on the back of Chewbacca, and I tried making tons of stuff out of fabric, nets, I tried a lot, but I couldn't figure out really how to make it work without magnets or something, so I just decided to leave it off, and all I did to Chewbacca was give him a repaint, and That's it. So I didn't do anything else to this minifigure. The satchel is exactly the same. The bandolier is exactly the same from last year. The bowcaster is exactly the same from next year. You get the idea. The sculpting, all that is a year old. So not much else to really talk about with Chewbacca. I just kind of wanted to throw him in here at least because he is very important to this film, and I did not want to leave him out of the assortment. So I thought it was important to at least do this quick segment. So that's Chewbacca. Alright, here is Lando Calrissian, a great addition to the original Star Wars cast, and seriously, played excellently by Billy Dee Williams. Such an amazing character. He brought so much charm to this role, and he's honestly one of my favorite Star Wars characters, hands down, so being able to make him was a great honor, and he's pretty simplistic. I actually made him in a single day, which was pretty cool because I needed to finish these figures, and despite his simplicity, I'm going to try and be as thorough as I possibly can during this segment, so I'm going to start with the head. The headpiece came from the 2018 Betrayal at Cloud City set. I took the minifigure, used the head, and it's a wonderful likeness to Mr. Billy Dee, especially this alternate expression. Look at that smile, those pearly whites. I love this figure. I love this head. I love the hairpiece. It screams Star Wars to me. This is such a great minifigure. Really happy with it. He also has a DH-17, another one. I gave one to Leia, of course. It comes from Eclipse Graphics, so link in the description. They are amazing. All I did just painted the tip silver, and that's about it. The other pieces that are really great is the capes. The capes are both made out of fabric, with one layer being gold, the other being a light bluish. And I could easily remove this. It's not a hard thing to do, but it's just like this. And I actually got away with making the ring around it. I just painted that. I didn't do anything else to it. But there is no there's no back detail to this figure, so there's no reason to turn this around. But yeah, it's a gold cape and then a light bluish cape that I made on top of it to give that effect of the flowing design. I would have loved to make an actual design on this, but I didn't think I had the time, and I honestly just wanted to make these figures simplistic. As I kind of mentioned, I love to take inspiration from Kenner figures, so being able to make them as simplistic and recognizable is the key to my new style, as I'm gonna start calling it so, and I've been calling it for a year or two now, so it's not new. But yeah, he's got a sand blue torso. I went with this over a light blue torso. I like the color of this a lot more. It's a bit more muted. It feels more Star Wars-y than a bright light blue Lego torso, so that's what I went with. I painted wrinkles similarly to the official design, and then the belt piece is really cool because it splits along the waist and the torso. That came out really nice. It's made out of metallic black, so if I move it at different angles, you can see how it shines, but it's really great. And the piece on top is a piece of rubber, and then it's painted also with diamonds and all sorts of designs. He's got a pair of dark blue legs and some black shoes. Forgive me, I've been recording for a while, so that's great. Another additional detail that I may have forgotten is also the rings on the arms. Those are painted in black all the way around, and even on the inside of the arm, if you can kind of see, so very, very simplistic minifigure. As I said, I basically made him in a day, but he is still an amazing minifigure. Here is Jedi Master Yoda, the green little dude that stole Luke's Illuminator. He made his appearance in this film, and making him was kind of required for doing an Empire Strikes Back showcase, and no lie, I've been really looking forward to being able to make such an iconic character like Yoda. It's kind of like when you make a Darth Vader or a Chewbacca. These Star Wars characters are so important to pop culture and to our lives in general, so immortalizing them into a tiny little minifigure is really cool. And also the fact that I've always wanted a Yoda custom, a Yoda figure, just a straight Yoda Lego minifigure when I was a kid, and they were always impossible to obtain, but this is fine. I managed to use the 2013 head, and it came out pretty good. This minifigure was heavily inspired by the Kenner figure, actually. I love the soft good robes of the original Yoda Kenner figure, and I wanted to do something similar, and I've been doing all fabric robes and trench coats and stuff like that in the past, so I decided to do it to Yoda. And no, I think it actually looks really good. I think it really makes the figure come together. I think without it, it wouldn't be as, you know, the way it looks now. But yeah, really like this. I used, you know, I painted these arms as well. These are, you know, I sculpted them and then painted them to get the details. And that's an electrical belt and all that. So, you know, really nice. He's got even little toe details down there. And, you know, removing this actually, it reveals kind of a little secret. If I can, I don't think I'm going to be able to do it, but, you know, you're going to have to ignore that. I can't do it. But there, you know, the legs underneath this are just straight painted brown. But, you know, he's got a little Harry Potter wand here. This is his staff, his cane, rather, I should say. And that looks really cool. So I think it's a great piece to use for that. It's perfect height, especially for him. I've tried using it in the past for taller figures, but it doesn't look well. But for Yoda, it's perfect. I also really like the detail that goes up here in the little box down here, which I forget what it's called. I think it's some sort of a whistle, maybe. But it's got these, you know, these little pieces that go up. It's a necklace, and it looks really nice. They don't always connect, but I think this one came out really great in that, you know, in that excuse. But and then the back of it has some more details. These are all painted. I believe these wrinkles are taken from the 2022 version, I believe, from the most recent Dagobah diorama that Lego put out. I believe that the wrinkles are kind of inspired by that, and some of it's my own design. The 3D pouch on here also looks really cool. I'm really happy with that 3D pouch. And then, as I forgot to say anything, the hair, that was all sculpted, and it came out really nice. It's very simplistic. It's just, and you know, it appears, and then I kind of morphed it, changed the color, and then played around with the sculpt. So that's Yoda's head, and then you know, his head is a very nice little rubber piece. I love these rubber pieces. I'm just gonna start. I'm gonna kind of make a tangent and just kind of play with the figure during this segment, because this is such a great little figure, and I'm so happy with this Yoda figure. I should have given him a green lightsaber or something, but that's kind of unnecessary. But you know, even by itself, it's such a great little minifigure. He is a bit tall, so you know, compared to a normal figure, I would have gotten Luke, but he's not in a good mood. But I would have compared him, but it's not necessary. Anyway, he's great. He's a bit taller than he should be. I realize that, but you know what? It looks great. I wouldn't sacrifice using the head. It's basically the same thing, like, you know, like Dobby that I mentioned earlier this year. The head mold is such an amazing piece, and I'm not gonna just, you know, sacrifice that. So, really great minifigure here in Yoda. Great little green dude, and I'm happy I made him. Next is Lobot, and I wanted to make Lobot for a few reasons. Number one, I wanted to have more minifigures from Cloud City. Number two, he's very Empire Strikes Back to me. And number three, he has an amazing dance in the Robot Chicken sketch, so of course he's worthy of a minifigure from me. And I mean, all being said, he was very simplistic, to be honest. I don't think I really spent a lot of time on this minifigure, I didn't think I needed to, because he's not that significant, so I didn't really try that hard. In fact, I didn't even paint the base gray. I just used Legos, and you know, I painted the back, and didn't, you know, do that much else. It was a very simplistic process, aside from the head, which I had to fully paint, which I'm not a huge fond of this face. It just doesn't very look low body to me, but it is based off the official head, and then this is, you know, the control panels all around the back. I wish that I had maybe extended these out a bit more, but they still look really great, especially from the side, and the fact that they're 3D and sculpted and not just painted on is a huge upgrade from the original head, so you know, I think it came out really great. He's got a very basic pair of pavement shoes with some details, white arms, a 3D piece down here, and that's really it. There's not much else to talk about with Lobot. I mean, his arms move, so that's fun. All minifigures can do that. Yay. I wish the head was a bit better, but that's really it for Lobot. I really do like the detail on the back over here, though. I really love the simplistic, you know, detail of the lines. That all came out really great. I love the simplicity of the torso in the front, too. You know, simple. I love the outline. Whatever. It's Lobot. Not much really else to say about the minifigure. And that's perfectly fine, because he's pretty much just a background character, and he's a great great addition to my LEGO Star Wars custom minifigure collection. He represents Empire Strikes Back very well, but not as well as the next minifigure. This is the classic Boba Fett from The Empire Strikes Back, not Return of the Jedi. It's honestly a mixture of both, but this is, you know, Boba Fett from the original trilogy. I've already done the modern Boba Fett from the Book of Boba Fett, so I got to use another few pieces from Nate's minifigures. I didn't get to use an entire cast. I actually had to sculpt a lot of this, so everything on this except for the gauntlets and the helmet is, and I suppose the jetpack, which is a different piece, but everything else is sculpted by me. The leg pieces down here, the chest armor, the shoulder pads, it was a crazy process, especially the belts. Oh my gosh, I hate sculpting pouches, but I'm so pleased with this minifigure. It is, as of now, my favorite minifigure of 2022. It is phenomenal. I'm so happy that this came out this way and that I was able to do this. So I don't even know where to start. We'll start with the carbine. That is the an E3 carbine that is also by Eclipse Graphics. So it's another piece by him or by that industry. So that's pretty nice. Probably not going to remove it out of the hand, or I will, because why not? So let's go ahead and be very gentle. Okay, you're bending the entire figure. That's not what I want. I just want to take this out of the hand. Alright, there you go. Okay, you were holding onto that a little bit too strong, Boba Fett. But anyway, if you can see this, it's painted with some gunmetal, and then the scopes are painted, and then there's also a lot of detail that's down here. I'll give a better look at this specific detail in a second, but there's also a strap that looks really nice as well. So yeah, that's the blast carbine. The rest of the figure is also really nice. I would love to be able to close the arms or move the arms all the way down, but the pockets are there. So I'll start with some of the sculpting. The knee pieces down here, these are sculpted, and those are always fun, and they're painted in yellow, of course. The pads down here are also sculpted. Those pieces are sculpted in, as well as the crotch piece that's sculpted. The pouches are also sculpted on the belts, as well as the pockets on either side, which are on the sides of the figure, unfortunately, instead of the front, because I couldn't fit them really there. That's just not something that I was able to do, so those are sculpted. As I mentioned, the chest piece is also fully sculpted, which was difficult. I had to dry sculpt that, so I sculpted just a flat layer and cut around it to make the shape, so that was a lot of fun. The shoulder pads are also sculpted, and those look really nice. The insignia this time is painted extremely clean, so that turned out great. A few of my other favorite parts include the cloth here, or the cape piece. This is another fabric element. The fabric cape is also really nicely painted. It's got the line straight down, as well as some wrinkles, and the jetpack is also there. Okay, I gotta slow down, because there's so much on this minifigure to dissect, so we'll keep just trying. The gauntlets are also from Tumino, so it's another collaborative piece. It's the same way I did the gauntlets for the older Boba Fett. I basically did the exact same things as I did before, including painting almost the exact same designs on each gauntlet, except there's a little bit more detail on the left gauntlet this time with the rocket. And then there's a bit of detail down here as well, if you can kind of make it out. There's that stuff too. And then, moving to the back, I'll kind of show you there is a bit of fabric right under there, as well as fabric on the front of the torso, that red piece, that's a fabric thing. But, there's a few things underneath there. There's a three-dimensional belt down there as well, and this is a sculpted wire that's hanging down. So if you can make that out, it's there. There's a 3D holster on the side. It's simple as painted, just like that. And as I slowly transition to the back, let's talk about the jetpack. The jetpack is not accurate to Empire Strikes Back, unfortunately, but I was not able to get one in, so what I decided to do was use an official LEGO jetpack and painted it to the best of my ability of the jetpack. So I've technically already painted this detail on the older Boba Fett. It's the exact same design, but it's a little bit simpler this time around, just because it's a little bit of a smaller thing, but I still managed to pack a lot of detail into the jetpack. It still looks really great, and I glued it to the back, as well as, it kind of clamps down this fabric piece, so that's not going anywhere, and it kind of holds down the figure, as well as making this look a little bit more natural. Instead of draping over the entire arm, it's more localized in this section here, so that came out really nice as well. This piece is is also a three-dimensional rope, or it's a string. As you know, I love using three-dimensional practical pieces, so that's something that I decided to throw on. It's a string, the same string I used for Spider-Man webbing, which I've been working on the Spider-Man figures, so that's coming up at some point, so there's that as well. These pieces on the arm are also three-dimensional. They are electrical tape bands, and I painted some stitching pattern. Not something that I typically do, but I decided to give it a shot, and I think it came out really great. There's also some wrinkle details on the torso. This is actually some of my favorite parts of the entire figure because it just looks so clean, so I'm really happy with that. And now I can talk about the helmet, which is, of course, from Nate's Minifigs. And this was one of the pieces that I decided to get in, and it looks great. You know, it's Nate's Minifigs. It's a practical piece that looks amazing. My favorite part of the helmet are actually the lines right here. Those came out really great. And the minimal weathering that I did do also came out really, you know, it was fine. I'm not a huge fan of weathering. Some of you may know that already. But I needed to at least throw in some bits where it was the most prevalent, kind of use the Hot Toys figure for reference, because it was harder to find clear images of the original Empire Strikes Back outfit. But this is also accurate detail, and then the antenna, whatever, it's all there. So I guess the scope I should have called it, my bad. But yeah, the red on the visor, that turned out really great. The gold down here, also really great. I want to keep talking about this minifigure because I feel like there's so much more that I could bring up, but it's just a really great minifigure. Actually, I have one more detail. There is Tamir Morrison's likeness, one of the clone trooper heads, one of the newer LEGO clone trooper heads that I painted a neck onto, so that's a little detail that I did not want to forget, and it just very peacefully fits on top of the helmet like so. So, yeah, Boba Fett. I'm really pleased with this minifigure, if you couldn't already tell, but I gotta move on to the next figure. The second to last minifigure is not that exciting. It's Admiral Piet from the Empire. I simply just wanted to have an Imperial officer minifigure, and I went with Piet just because he's one of my favorites in the film. There was a lot to choose from, admittedly, but I like Piet a lot, so I decided to go ahead and make him, and honestly, he doesn't really even look like the character. I went with I believe it's his head, or maybe it's I think it's just an Imperial officer head, but I just wanted to kind of make someone look terrible. I wanted someone to look really evil and devious as an Imperial officer, and I wanted to make the hat and hair combo, so yeah, very simplistic minifigure, but he gets the job done. He's still a really nice minifigure. He's still really simple and really unique, if you ask me. And he goes, really nicely along other Stormtrooper minifigures and the Emperor himself. So it looks really nice. And he's basically made the same way as Grand Moff Tarkin from last year. He's got the fabric waistcoat. He's got the 3D belt. He's got the the boots and whatnot. He's got the 3D rank up here. And move to the back. It's even simpler, actually, than Grand Moff Tarkin last year. He does have the hair and hat combo, which was a lot of fun to make. That was just, lots of cutting up. I used a Mutt Williams hairpiece as a base and just kind of, sculpted in the areas that were needed to be filled in, and that was about it. And I sculpted onto the head, not the hat, so it turned out really well, and I like the likeness on the inside of it. One of my favorite details of this minifigure is actually the gauntlets here, or the glove tops. They are so simple and so unique, and I just love them so much. So it's a very simple detail, but it does look really nice, and I'm pretty happy with it. So that's it for Admiral Piet. Let's go on to the final minifigure. Once again, we're concluding a LEGO Star Wars minifigure showcase video with none other than Darth Vader himself. And I knew that I had to do something to my New Hope version. He is so pivotal in The Empire Strikes Back. And I was originally pretty satisfied with my New Hope version. I thought that it was fine the way it was and didn't need any upgrades. But I was so excited and so pleased with Hayden Christensen's portrayal of Anakin Skywalker yet again in Kenobi. And that was enough to inspire me to touch up my old Vader. And as soon as I got started, I realized there was a lot wrong with the original figure. The control panel in the middle of the torso was getting stuck behind the robes and it wasn't symmetrical, and as soon as I noticed that, it was time for me to redo the entire robes. So I used my brand new fabric, redid everything aside from the arms and the legs. Everything on this figure is brand new and I am so pleased with it. He's got 3D sculpted belt pouches, the control panel in the middle, this thing, shoulder armor, and of course a brand new set of fabric, robes, and line details, and they came out so great. I'm really pleased with this. It's honestly a very simple looking Darth Vader custom. It's pretty standard, but I'm really pleased with the simplicity of it. It really goes along with the Kenner ideal that I want to try and capture, and so I'm really, really satisfied with this minifigure. I love the change from the metallic black to the gunmetal silver on the arms. I think that they came out really great. I also touched up pieces on the helmet. I painted the breathers over here, and as well as the nose piece a little bit. I gave those a little bit more detail, because originally I had just painted the tips silver and I wanted to do a little bit more than last time. I also redid the gauntlets to remove some of the unnecessary detail that I tried to shove in. I would have rather tried to have sculpted that. And when I get around to doing Return of the Jedi Vader, I might go ahead and redo this again and sculpt the gauntlets to have that bit of horizontal detail, because I left that off for right now and it's completely fine the way it is. The lightsaber is also from Nate Mates and Legomatic 9, so that's something that came from them that I painted up, and it looks really great, complements the figure exactly. I also outlined the belt pieces, because that was, I thought, a pivotal part of the minifigure that needed to be done, and it pops so much. I'm really glad I did that. I kept the legs the exact same. They were as intricate as they originally were with the metallic black and the gray, so I didn't think I needed to touch anything on that. Standard Lego cape, and also the Anakin Skywalker head, which I would love to update to maybe one of the new Kenobi head prints that are coming out, but that is the exact same head print, and there is nothing on the back, much like the original figure, so nothing necessary there. Other than that, this is a great Darth Vader custom, very simplistic, but also, it doesn't need to be anything more than that. It serves its purpose, and it's really clean, which is my the perfect Vader custom in my eyes. So, yeah, that's it for Darth Vader, and that's it for the rest of the Empire Strikes Back figures. This has been months in the making. I've been working on these customs since March, so I hope that you've enjoyed this showcase. I hope that you've enjoyed each and every one of these minifigures, but let's go ahead and wrap up this video. Alright, there we go. That was all of the minifigures from me. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you've enjoyed this showcase. I wanted to go in depth much more than I usually do. I wanted to be as thorough as I possibly could because these films are such a big part of who I am today, and doing a showcase based on them with justice is the right thing to do. As I've said, making these figures was a lot of fun, and hopefully you've had fun watching this showcase. If you enjoyed, give this video a like and share it with other people who might also like this. That would be very much appreciated. If you have any thoughts, questions, or critiques, please don't hesitate to let me know what you think down in the comment section below. I read each and every comment I get, which is never a lot, so feedback is always really nice. Remember to follow my social media pages for more updates, announcements of what I'm doing next, and custom edits featuring my minifigures. As always, you can find links down below. But yeah, I guess that's it for the Empire figures. Honestly, I'm really happy this project is done and finished. I kind of felt like I'd never be able to finish them, and that it just kept getting delayed and delayed, and it was really disheartening. But so great, so glad that they're done, and I have a good feeling of the showcase so far throughout editing. I think it's gonna be one of my best. So that's it for me. So I'll see you next time. As always, goodbye.